I'm going to give you a demo of the key features in Resource Guru. Let's start in the schedule. This is the heart of Resource Guru. It's where you manage resource schedules and where you can see the big picture, who's available and who isn't. All of your resources will be displayed down the left-hand side of the screen, and along the top, you'll see the timeline. It's very easy to click and drag or scroll around the timeline. You can also right-click and drag to get more control and scroll diagonally. You can also use these arrows to jump forwards or backwards, or simply use the month and year navigation at the top. In the zoomed out view, you'll generally see between 4 and 6 weeks depending on your screen resolution, but if you prefer, you can switch to the zoomed in view to see a week at a time instead. Resource Guru will remember your preferences, so you won't have to keep changing this setting unless you want to. Creating bookings in Resource Guru is really easy. Just click or click and drag over multiple days and you'll see the new booking form appear. If you have a really long booking that is going to span many weeks or months, you can simply edit the dates of the booking here. Resource Guru has the flexibility to create duration bookings, for example 4 hours, as well as time-specific bookings, for example 9 a.m. till 10 a.m. Here is where you can specify which project or client the booking is for, and if you have sufficient permissions, you can even create projects and clients on the fly like this. The billable status will be set automatically from your project settings, but you can always override it here. Use the details field to add any extra information relating to the booking, for example, a short brief, task list, or a link to an online document. And finally, the booker will default to you, the person making the booking, but you can easily book on behalf of others by clicking here and selecting somebody else. If you try to create a booking which doesn't fit within someone's availability, you'll see a booking clash warning. You'll have the option to go back and edit the booking, or you can add it to the waiting list. This means that overbookings become a thing of the past. Bookings on the waiting list will be displayed on your dashboard as well as over in the reports, which is great for capacity planning. It helps you see who's overbooked so you can take corrective action in advance. Resource Guru also lets you keep track of your team's time off as well as other resource downtime. You can schedule time off for an individual resource or for multiple resources at the same time. For example, let's say you have some people working in the States and some people working in the UK. If you want to schedule a public holiday on Thanksgiving for your team in the States but not for your team in the UK, just apply the relevant filter in the schedule and then click the currently filtered option over on the new time off form. There are different types of time off to choose from, but you can also leave the type blank, which will result in it being categorised under Other in your reports. Add any extra details relevant to the time off here, and change the booker if you're scheduling time off on behalf of somebody else. It's also worth mentioning that time off subtracts from a resource's normal availability, so your reports will always remain accurate and your utilisation rates won't be skewed. It's very quick and easy to edit bookings and time off in Resource Guru. You can drag to move, click on an event to edit the details, and extend or contract. If you have a team of people working on the same booking, you can filter your schedule to view just that team, then copy the booking by holding Shift and dragging it to other resources. If you're editing a multi-day booking, you'll have the option to edit or delete the day that you've clicked on, or the entire booking. And you can split the booking too by clicking on these scissors. Each resource has two rows on the schedule, the booking area and the availability bar. The availability bars are a unique feature which calculate how much free time your resources have available, so you can see at a glance who's free and who's fully booked. The availability bars are hidden by default. You can turn them on or off by clicking this icon. You can set the normal availability of your individual resources over in the resources section. This is the availability that repeats on a weekly basis. Sometimes though, you might need to book somebody outside of their normal working hours, for example on the weekend. By clicking or clicking and dragging on the availability bar, you can create an availability exception. If you're making the same change to more than one day, edit the first day and click on this little arrow to copy that change to other days. You can also flag overtime by clicking here. You may have noticed that bookings in the schedule all have different colours on them. This menu lets you colour your bookings by project, client, or by booker. This helps you to pick out the bookings that you're most interested in while still viewing your resources workload in context. Use the name search to quickly focus on specific resources. You can also filter your schedule here. If you filter by project or client, you'll see only resources that have been booked for the projects or clients that you select. And when you click on the other options in the filters menu, you'll be able to filter by resource type, name, job title, or any custom field that you've created in your account. These custom fields are specific to this demo account, but you can create any fields that are relevant to your business. So if, for example, I need to find a resource with CSS and HTML skills, I can enter those skills here, choose Match All, and maybe I also want to see the resources in our London office. Applying these filters will remove any resources from the schedule that don't match my criteria, so now I can easily see who can take the job on and when they're available. If you regularly use the same filters, you can just save them to make it really quick and easy to jump between them in future. To create some custom fields, just head on over to your settings and then click Resources. Now click on the Custom Fields tab. You can add as many custom fields with as many options as you like. Let's add a field called Skills with the options HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. Specify which resource type it belongs to here and whether or not it's a required field. Once you click Add Custom Field, you'll see it appear in your Resources section and in the Filters menu on the schedule and in the reports. Now we're going to have a look over at the Resources section. This is where you create and manage your resources. Resource Guru lets you schedule different types of resources, not just people. The functionality between people and non-human resources is slightly different, and you'll notice a few changes between the forms when you're adding different types of resources. Let's have a look at adding a new person. Much of this form is self-explanatory, but there are a few things worth mentioning. You have the option to invite people to join your account, but you don't have to. If you do invite people, you can set their permissions using one of the presets or choose your own custom permissions. The dashboard slider will be greyed out because everyone you invite to your account will have access to their own dashboard by default, but you can fully customize someone's permissions for all other sections of the app. Further down the form, you'll see the time zone field. If you have people in multiple time zones, this is a great feature that lets you see exactly where everyone is right there on the schedule. Underneath the time zone field, you can edit the person's normal availability. If you don't edit this, it will just default to the default availability you have set up in your account. If you need to change the default account availability, you can do that over in your settings. Here, you'll be able to specify whether someone is bookable or not. So, if you're adding a manager or an administrator or anyone who doesn't need to be scheduled, untick the box and they won't be shown on the schedule or in the reports. Finally, you'll see your custom fields if you've created any, and there's no limit to the number of options you can label someone with. To edit, delete, or archive a resource, just click on their profile. Your reports will always remain historically accurate, so if you do archive or delete a resource, or a project or client for that matter, you don't need to worry about your data becoming skewed. If you report on a period where a resource was active, you'll still see their data in the reports. You won't be charged for any resources that are in the archive, so it's a great place to put people who come and go, like contractors. You can unarchive resources at any time, and this will save you from having to add them again from scratch. It's very easy to create clients and projects in Resource Guru. You can assign each project to a client, so we'd recommend creating your clients first, and then you'll see them in the client field when you come to add your projects. The project code field will be pre-populated with an automatically generated code, but you can either delete this or manually enter your own code if you prefer. Choose whether your project is billable or non-billable by default. This setting will be used automatically for all new bookings for the project, but you can always override it for individual bookings if necessary. The colours that you assign to the projects and clients will be the colours that are displayed on your bookings in the schedule when you colour by project or colour by client. You can create an unlimited number of projects and clients in Resource Guru, and it won't affect the cost of your subscription. Everyone you invite to join your Resource Guru account will have access to their own personal dashboard, and what they see here will depend on whether they are a booker or a resource. If they're a booker, they'll see all the bookings they've made, and if they're a resource, they'll see all the bookings that have been made for them. It's the perfect place for your team to keep track of exactly what they're working on and when. Changes to the schedule are available here immediately, so there's no longer a need to send out email updates to your staff. But if you do want email updates, don't worry. Resource Guru can send a daily schedule email to anyone who wants one. You can opt in or out in the settings. The dashboard will display all of your bookings for the current day, but you can also switch to a week view if you prefer. Anyone with sufficient permissions can add their own time off via the dashboard. If you'd rather people didn't have access to do this, you can remove this link by changing their permissions over in the resources section. Resource Guru also lets people sync their calendar events with their own external calendar, such as Outlook, Google Calendar, or Apple Calendar. Click this link to get your unique URL. You can find a full walkthrough of how to sync with the most popular calendar tools over in our Help Center. Finally, at the top of your dashboard, you'll see the waiting list. This is where you can keep track of all those unconfirmed bookings that still need to be resolved. Resource Guru's powerful reports let you easily view utilization rates, understand how much capacity you have, and really drill down into the numbers. At the top of the report, you'll see some headline numbers relating to all the resources you're reporting on, including the total utilization, overtime, waiting list, and time off, as well as a breakdown of billable and non-billable time. This information gives you an overview of what's happening with all of your resources. You can also see these metrics on an individual basis next to each resource. In the resources report, you can switch between booked hours and downtime, so it's easy to focus in on exactly who's spent their time doing what. Click on any of the column headers in your reports to sort by that column. If you want to see who has the most hours on the waiting list, for example, just click here. And for a more granular view on exactly how someone's time has been spent, you can click on any individual resource. From here, you'll be able to see exactly how much time has been booked on each project or client, or how much time off they've had, and for what reason. Finally, at the top of the report, you can download detailed reports in CSV format, so you can analyse the data in a spreadsheet if you want to. You can also apply filters, so if you just want to report on the utilisation of your design department, for example, that's no problem. And you can report on any custom timeframe that you choose. In the projects and clients reports, you'll also find a summary at the top, including details of billable versus non-billable hours, as well as a breakdown for each individual project or client below. And if you click on an individual project or client, you will see a list of all the resources that were booked for it during the timeframe that you're reporting on. To try Resource Guru app for yourself, sign up for a free 30-day trial at resourceguruapp.com. It takes less than 30 seconds and you won't need any credit card details. We hope you found this walkthrough useful, but if you have any questions at all, please feel free to contact us. Happy scheduling!